Church family, I'm so incredibly grateful and excited to be your pastor. By God's grace, we have for over 16 months been on a spiritual journey together called Greater Still. We have witnessed God's immeasurable and abundant blessing upon us, as total giving to Greater Still has now surpassed $11.64 million. Greater Still, from the beginning, has been a three-part generosity journey focusing on what God can do in and through us for greater ministry, greater missions, and a greater future. God has been so faithful as we've seen God's favor on our ministries and our mission efforts. However, I want to focus on an exciting update in regard to Greater Future. Excitingly, we have surpassed our 70% threshold for our Phase 1 $6 million project. Phase 1 consists of a remodel of our worship center, an expansion and update of our atrium, a relocation of our church offices, and new classroom for groups on the north side of our worship center. We anticipate construction beginning at the end of September, so I'm excited to announce that September 17th will be our last Sunday in our current worship center. And beginning on September the 24th, we will be moving our worship services to the gym, where we will meet for worship at 9:30 and 11 a.m. Churches by Daniels, our design build firm, has notified us construction for Phase 1 should last between 9 to 10 months from our start date. I realize this information seems very fresh, but we've been preparing for quite some time. We've provided updates in our Sunday morning worship services, our most recent leadership summit, and to our deacons at previous deacons meetings. I'm so excited about what God is going to do in and through us. Later this week, our executive pastor, Steve Smith, will release another video providing further details and logistics for our Phase 1 transition. Church, as we enter into this pivotal season, I want to encourage you to be prayerful, flexible, and expectant. May we have a posture of fervent prayer for our hearts and our church during this season. Be prayerful. May we be flexible and ready to adapt as the Lord directs and leads our ministries during this season. Be flexible. Finally, may we be expectant and quick to obey what it is that God is asking each of us. I'm so grateful for you and to serve as your pastor. May Paul's prayer in Ephesians 3, 20 and 21 be our prayer during this incredible season of ministry. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we can ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Church family, you are loved. I'll see you this Sunday.